Hey, what's up, guys? Glock9 here, and welcome back to Horde Every Night in Ghost Town. It is the morning of day 15, and the first thing we're going to do is head down the road and pick up the supply drop that we never got yesterday. I've got it marked on the map with the red flag, and then we got a lot of work to do around town. The gallows, however, is looking pretty damn sweet. A little bit of upgrading we can continue to do to this place, so it's more of a fortress, you know? Because right now, the support pillars are all reinforced concrete, which is great, but the rest of it is really just kind of wood and upgraded to the first iron at some points. But yeah, the gallows could still use a lot of upgrading. These two buildings need some fixing up, especially the bookstore. I think that's what I'm going to focus on tonight, is these two buildings. Get them both repaired and possibly run a bridge between the two. So that's kind of the plan for tonight. Another plan I had for today was to start crafting ammo. Because we have a good amount of nitrate powder and coal, so we could go to the chem station and cook up a bunch of gunpowder. But then we need casings and we need bullet tips. And in order to craft those, we need a tool and die set, which we don't have, and you can't craft, you have to find one of those. And, you know, we don't have shit left to loot, really, other than trash and cars and stuff, and finding a tool and die set. Doing that is going to be damn near impossible. The only other option we have is to find one at a trader and buy one. I don't know off the top of my head how much those things cost. I got to imagine they're pretty pricey. And I don't think we're going to make it to a trader today. But if we don't, that will definitely be on the to-do list for tomorrow. Is head to that we can hit up both traders, the one up north and then the one down in the burnt forest on the way home, and see if either of them have a tool and die set and what the cost is. Let's kill this chicken right here because we need feathers. Oh, did we get it? Yes, we did. Shit, we don't have our knife though. That's right. We'll chop them up with the axe then, I guess. So yeah, that'll be on the plan for. Well, maybe we'll make it to the trader today. I doubt it though, just because there's so much work to do. Come here, biatch. Bam! Oh, that's ridiculous. I should really start fighting with the axe. It's a bit slow. I don't really like heavy melee weapons, you know? They're too slow for me. I like just continuously rapping them in the head with the bat, but... Oh, that's pretty fun. When you're dealing with just one zombie, the heavy melee weapons aren't an issue, but dealing with many, I would rather something light and quick. But anyway, guys, let's get to the supply drop. See what we got in there, and then get to work in town. And like I was saying, because of all the work that needs to be done, I doubt we'll get to the trader today. If not, we'll definitely hit up both traders tomorrow, see if we can get a tool and die set so we can start crafting our own ammo. Because if we can't start crafting ammo, it's going to be real hard to take this much farther. Because I expect a radiated zombie to show up tonight, and if not tonight, definitely within the next two nights. Now granted, the traps do a lot of good work. But, dude, you can't fight radiated zombies with arrows. Maybe flaming arrows, but you just can't, dude. You need ammo. And if we can't get a tool and die set and start crafting our own, we're going to be screwed. Alright, we probably should head home and unload, but before we do, let's just use the little bit of wood we have to start doing some repair work to the hardware store. We need to make frames, though, first. We don't have many. I did make a good amount of spikes last night, 56 of them, but we're definitely going to need more than that. So, let's do the repair work we can with the wood we have. We'll go home, we'll unload, and we'll grab some more wood. Okay, that's it. That's all we can do right now. Let's get home. Oh, we've got to search this bird's nest here. Let's get home, unload, and then we'll get some more wood. And I'm using wood to do the repairs on the hardware store and the bookstore today because, well, first, I don't really give a shit. You know what I mean? If these places come tumbling down, great. That'll be fun. You know, hopefully we'll survive. But also, I want to see if last night was a fluke at the hardware store. Let's see how well it holds up with now mostly wood on the outside. Ooh, that's a snake. Where is he, by the door? No. Where is that guy? I know I heard one. Let's jump down here. There he is. Come here, you little bastard. Oh, shit. I don't like using melee weapons against snakes, because they can strike at you pretty easy. Using arrows is not so fun either. Come on. There we go. All right. Let's chop this guy up, get inside, finish unloading and organizing, and then get back to work. Oh, I saw something move over there. Let's see what we got. Oh, looks like we trapped a pig. Poor little guy. I guess we're gonna have to murder him. It's the only solution here. Oh, one shot. And he's falling down the pit. Alright, let's chop him up. Okay, that's it. We almost got it filled up in here. How many more can we make? Whoops. Spikes. 20. Let's get them all moving. We're out of wood. Let's go chop down some more trees and sustain some life while we're at it. Before we finish laying the spikes down in the hardware store, let's get some repair work done to the bookstore here. Okay, we got a supply drop to the north here. Not too far, just in the burnt forest. We may go pick that up before the night's over. Again, as always, if we don't, we'll make sure we mark it on the map so we can grab it tomorrow. Throw another set of bars right here to prevent the zombies from jumping up. They were able to get up there if I stay in that location, and I should be able to still throw Molotovs down on them from there. Probably wind up setting myself on fire, but hey, what's new, right? Okay, the hardware store is done. That block looks pretty damaged. Let's replace that with a wood block. And then let's go get that supply drop, grab a bunch more wood, and then we'll build this bridge between the bookstore and the hardware store. Also got to drop some more spikes down at the bookstore as well. Here we go. Let's see what we got here. Another hunting rifle. A little bit more 7.62. And man, we have so much canned food. I probably should start selling this shit. Alright, so I think I'm going to start this bridge from the window on the bookstore all the way to the right and run it right over there to the hardware store. That should line up pretty perfectly, hopefully. We're going to have to obviously knock a hole into the hardware store because there's no window there, but that's fine. No big deal. Let's just get up here and get started. We'll knock these bars out, and this is where we'll start the bridge. And then we'll put in support columns probably every 6 blocks or so. And we should only need about 2 of them running from here to the hardware store. Okay, that's a start. Let's finish building it here, and then we'll upgrade all of these blocks. And I'm using wood because I'm not going to be using this bridge to fight on. I was thinking about using the rebar frames and concrete for the support columns, you know, so that obviously they can take more damage. But like I said, I'm not going to be using this to fight on. We could eventually upgrade it and then put, you know, bars on the side and put spikes underneath. But right now, I don't see this bridge as a way to fight the horde. I just see it as a way to quickly get from the hardware store to the bookstore or vice versa if one of them fails or if something, you know, some shit happens. Who knows, right? So as long as we don't stand on top of it. You know what? Instead, let's put the door right here, since one of the blocks is already wood. But yeah, I'm not going to be standing on top of this thing during Horde Night, and as long as I'm not doing that, they shouldn't attack the support columns. They have no reason to if I'm not anywhere near it. Alright, there we go. And now I'm going to hold the horde down at the hardware store tonight. But like I was saying earlier, because all the repair work was done with wood, who knows what's going to happen, right? So if the building starts taking on way more damage than I expect, you know what? Let's upgrade these a little bit more, though, at the feet, at least. Alright. But yeah, if this building starts taking on way more damage than I thought or whatever, or if it just seems like, oh shit, this is going to come down, this is not going to work, then I can just get out the, you know, run across the bridge to the bookstore, lead them over there, and continue fighting them over there. So that's really what the bridge is for. It's not for fighting. I'm not going to be shooting down on them from up there. It's just a quick, easy way to get between both bases. Alright, we're loaded up, and I'm taking the AK with me tonight. Fuck it. I've been holding off on using this thing, but it's coming out tonight, because I expect at least a few cops to show up tonight, and possibly irradiated zombies. So, we're going to be conservative with the ammo. We'll only use the AK either on a cop or on irradiated. Otherwise, we'll just try and get away with our bow, and maybe the Magnum. We'll just see how it goes. But let's go ahead and lay down the spikes that we have here. We're probably going to have to make more, even though I don't want to use all my wood, and I don't feel like chopping down any more trees. Let's just make, like 10 more spikes. Hopefully that will work, and that leaves us a little bit of wood. I want to head over to our mine and do a little bit of mining. We need more raw iron to throw in the forge, and I'd like to see if I can go down a little bit deeper and grab some oil shale. Alright, you know what? We better cut down some of these trees, because I'm hearing some zombies, but I don't see them. Too many damn trees over here. Here comes one of them. I gotta assume it's a wandering horde right here. We need the wood anyway. We only have like 100 pieces. Oh yeah, here we go. I see at least 3. Oh shit, did I just crush that one with the tree? Dude, I think I just crushed one with the tree. I didn't think that was possible. Alright, well I hear more of these fuckers, but I can't see them. I'm such an idiot, all these trees in the way. I definitely don't want to get down in that mine, because I know there are more around. Let's get the bike out of the way here. Here we go. Alright, well, there can't be many more left. Here we go. Come on out. Where the hell are they? It's like they're hanging out in there just waiting for me to come in. Here we go. Oh, shit. I knew that was going to happen. I was trying to avoid coming into this mess where I can't see anything. I think these are the last two, though. Right? No, here another one. The last thing we want to do is get cornered inside the mine. Come on, just come out here already. It's wasting time here. Alright, we're in the clear. Now, there is still plenty of iron down here left to be mined, but what I really want is the oil shale. And from what I heard, you gotta go deep to get the oil. So, I'm gonna start digging down, but I also want to open this up a bit. I want to make the mine deeper, but I don't want it to just be a straight hole going down. I'd like to be able to crawl out of it if I can. Damn. This is like all iron. Yeah, I'm like surrounded by it. Below me also is iron. So, let's grab some. We might as well. We need it. And we're going to have to save the oil shale for another day because it's getting late. Alright, let's take the bike, park it behind our house, get inside there real quick, drop some stuff off, get the forge running, maybe cook some food just so that's done and out of the way, and then let's get in position, wait for the horde. Alright, let's lay down the rest of the spikes we have here, and then we'll get in position in the hardware store. And what is this guy doing? Trying to break in the bookstore? Come on, buddy. Oh, that was bullshit. That was bullshit. He knows it. Sometimes their reach is just better. Sometimes. I don't know. Alright. Here comes another dude. And it sounds like another one. And now it sounds like they're beating. They are. Oh my god. They respawned inside the bookstore. That is such bullshit. Oh my god. They're breaking out. This is exactly what I need to be dealing with right before the horde. And they're up there too. Alright, we better do something about it. Oh shit! I hit the spikes there. We lost a decent amount of health there too. I'm just gonna go ahead and use one of these first aid bandages. Might be a waste, but whatever. That will give us some health back and at least fill our max health bar. I really hope no zombies spawned in the hardware store. That's gonna be even a bigger problem. Let's go ahead and open this up here and just let him out. Oh, there's a runner in there, too. This is great. Alright. We gotta break this last block and just let him out. I don't think zombies could spawn on the bottom floor of the hardware store because it's lined with spikes, but they may have spawned up on the second floor. Alright, damn. Talk about screwing up your plans. Here, we'll upgrade this block here, but I don't want to do too much work in here. I don't have that much more wood, and I'm gonna need some of it to possibly do some repair work during the night. So let's just get up into the hardware store, make sure no zombies respawned up there, and, you know, just get in position, wait for the horde. Okay, we're good up here. We're just gonna go around and make sure none of these wood bars need any slight repairs. Some of them do. And then that's pretty much it. The only thing I forgot was torches down on the first floor. I said I was gonna put some in to light it up down there, and I totally forgot. But, not a big deal. We got our mining helmet. We got torches on up here. It's pretty friggin' bright in here. I think we'll be fine. Let's, upgrade some of these spikes here in the middle, though, with the iron. Alright, let's just go make sure we're clear over here and repair that platform that the zombies were beaten on before. Alright, here we go. Got some coming down the street right there. And, don't see any back here yet. Hopefully they come running in through the front door. We probably should have made some more openings. Yep, because I knew it, man. Same problem we were having the beginning of last night, which is they just start beating on the walls instead of coming in through the door. Maybe we should have opened it up down there a little bit more. I guess they're going to do that for us, though. Oh, shit. Is that a cop? I think that's a cop. Coming in through the window right there. Oh yeah, that is a cop. Let's get the AK out. We'll just tap him. You know, tag him. You gotta be careful. You do not want him to explode, and he's dead. Beautiful. Yeah, I mean, I don't mind a little bit of cop puke. But if one gets in here and blows up, that causes all sorts of problems. And we already have all sorts of problems. Look at this. They're breaking in two different locations, maybe three. I don't know what's going on behind me. This is not good. I just want them to make an opening already and flood in here so the spikes can start doing some work. Here we go. They're starting to flood in. Let's get some fire down there. I was just going to say, once I can get them to get in here, get some fire going. There we go. That's nice. Yeah, get inside, guys. Stop beating on the walls. Oh, shit. That whole side of the building just fell. It's not good. Oh, my God. Oh, loot bag. Loot bag went down. Yeah, look at that, dude. They made a nice opening right there. That is not good. And that's what I was talking about earlier. Ooh, another loot bag. I was talking about this earlier, where if I feel like it's getting to a point where the building is losing its structural integrity, then I can just run across that ramp over to the bookstore. But I think we're good now. Oh, shit, another loot bag. That's three in, like, the first 30 seconds. But I think we're still looking. We're looking just fine right now. Nothing to worry about just yet. Another loot bag. Dude, there are four loot bags down there right now. Holy shit. You know what? I'm going to hold off on the fire for a second. There we go. Nice. They're all on fire down there. That's a beautiful thing. And the rest of the building looks pretty much intact. We're looking good. It's just the front left side that's missing. But as long as the other side of the building stays intact, we should be fine. So far, though, it's going pretty much the same as it was last night. Oh, there's a cop right there. Let's get the fire down here. Get the AK out. Here we go. Come on. I think he's dead. He is. I think I just heard another loot bag, and there's two more cops right there. Come on, you fuckers. One's dead. And he's dead, too. Beautiful. So that is four cops as of right now, and so far, no radiated zombies. That is a nice pile of bodies down there. There's a shitload of dogs down there, dude. Oh my god. Alright, I do not think this structure is in any jeopardy of falling. However, it's hard to get a decent shot down on these zombies because they're just running all over the place chaotic. So I'm going to see if I can lead them over here, get them to all run up this ramp, and it'll just be easier to get shots on them. Plus, there's some spikes down here that can do some work. If these zombies will behave and go for the ramp, what are they doing? Oh, they're right under me. Oh, they're hitting the spikes. Okay. Come up the ramp, though, you idiots. Ooh, she's dead. Stop beating on the walls. Come on. Come this way. What if we, maybe if we come out here? Come on, use the ramp. All right, well, that guy, I think they're all just caught up on the spikes right now, which is good. Let the spikes do some work. Whoops. Alright, this isn't a bad idea either. Use both bases, you know, so both of them take a little bit of damage, but none of them, you know, neither of them get completely wrecked. Let's see if this is going to work now, if I'm going to set myself on fire. Oh shit, that worked! I definitely thought I was going to set myself on fire right there. Beautiful. Come on. Oh shit, vulture! Oh, we fell. Son of a bitch. Come here, you goddamn bird. We're bleeding out. Where the hell are my bandages at? I didn't put them on my tool belt. Where are they? Oh, here they are. Duh. Okay. Where are the zombies? The hell just happened? Is that it? Where's the bird? We killed the bird? Oh, there's the bird. Dude, what the hell just happened? It was like all of a sudden, all hell broke loose. I fell, and now it's just over? I don't know, but let's grab these loot bags. Dude, I thought there was at least a good handful of zombies left. I don't know, maybe they all got hung up on the spikes? I let off a few rounds with the AK when I fell down. I was bleeding out, shit was blurry. I didn't think I got any hits, though. I just started shooting and ran. Alright, I'll take it. It's like all of a sudden, it just ended so abruptly. Look at how many fucking dogs there are right here. Alright, well, both bases took a little bit of damage, but neither are that bad. Looks like a zombie was beaten on one of these support pillars for the bridge, too. Not sure why, but one of them felt the need to do that. But that was not so bad. You know, it's probably a good idea to do something like this, run back and forth between the two bases, because like I said, then neither of them take too much damage, but then of course you need to repair both of them the next day. So, I don't know. That was a good night. All was going well until that goddamn vulture showed up, and then I fell, and I thought we were going to have a decent fight on foot. I even considered running for the gallows, and then I turned around it's over. So I don't know what the hell happened there. The gallows is still in pretty much pristine condition. Needs some upgrading, though, especially if we're going to start dealing with these higher-end hordes over here. You know what we could do is upgrade these poles right here to reinforced concrete. Might as well do that now. And then, yeah, I'll spend the rest of the night cutting down trees, getting organized, and coming up with a plan for tomorrow. Not sure what we're going to do. You know, maybe should we go back to the gallows tomorrow night and see how it does? Or should we repair the bookstore and the hardware store, kind of give that another run? Or we should probably make another base, right? Why not? Let's do something completely different, maybe. So, I'll think about it. You know, the gallows or the jail, right? You got the gallows, the jail, and then the shotgun place. So maybe we'll connect the jail to the shotgun place and make a base out of the shotgun place. And if all hell breaks loose there, we can always escape to the jail and then the gallows. So let me put some thought into it, and we'll pick it up here on the morning of day 16. Guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope you're enjoying this series. Thank you for all the support. It really does mean a lot. If you're not already subscribed and you'd like to, that would be awesome. It really does help out the channel. You can also follow me on Twitter or Instagram. It's at Glock9Gamer. I follow all gamers back. Stick around for more Horde every night in Ghost Town, and I will catch you guys in the next episode.